Hello, hello. Welcome to my arts and crafts channel. We're going to make a watercolor painting of a parrot. And we're going to start with a simple sketch. I'll try to make a sketch using basic shapes for birds. Tummy will use oval, and then for its tail it goes like triangle shaped here. Hope you can see it well. And for its head we're going to use another oval shape, and let's see, you can always change a little bit here and there. The bird is going to be sitting on some branch. Here we'll put his feet. I'm not sure you call it feet or, I don't know. I guess it's not paws. Should be feet. Okay, and now here will be its wing, and then fix a little bit its head. I'll be using mostly blue colors, so prepare your blue paint. This will be the simple sketch, and I'm going to erase some of the lines, those that were mostly for building the picture. So all those lines that we don't need, we just erase. Paint and water. Okay, we'll start this part where it's going to be a little more in the shade. Dark. And then here I'm going to get more water. Pretty white and loose. Wash my brush and add some more clean water here. I'll drag some ink here. There you go, you pretty much can see the bird already. It's almost done, but not yet. Okay, now I'll get more intense, more dark color. More thick. And start adding some details here. With the tip of your brush, just make like little feathers. Get more blue color, this just means a little bit not what I wanted. Okay. There's our bird. I really like pets. I used to have different pets during my childhood. I had parrots and I had cats and dogs, fish. So for me it's very enjoyable to draw and paint animals. I know why. For me it's easier to do animals than flowers. Maybe if I was a flower person, I would find it easier to paint flowers. There you go. Just like that. Now I want to get black with blue and get these black spots on his face. It's kinda not black but like dark blue, but it's somewhere between black and blue. So I'm mixing both of them. Mm-hmm. A little bit more. Mm-hmm. Nostrils. Shape here. My kids are picking on me. I'm working on my balcony. Told them to do their homework. And now they're picking on me through the window and giggling. Lots of homework nowadays. During the quarantine, we have to do a lot of work and parents have to be involved a lot, especially for younger kids. I have to go to different websites, find all those assignments, make sure they submit their homeworks. Life is going on, even if we don't go to school physically, we have to do it at home. So there's our birdie. Now I'll just, oh, I forgot little, pardon, it's big. Let me see, little bird here. So I guess kids are not doing homework now. Now we'll get warm color for its beak here. And I need brown for the branch and for the little feet, bird's feet. Feet darker so they don't get mixed with the branch. Let it dry, and while it's drying, I will get black color for the eye. It's very, very dark, so just fill it with black paint. While you're working, you can always add shades here and there where you think it needs to be added. You have to always evaluate your painting as a whole piece. Like, you do a detail, then you look at it as a whole piece, see, check if anything is missing and you need to add something, and like go back and forth from the detail to the general whole picture. That's how I've been taught at university. sheet on the bottom of the branch. And I also was thinking about adding a little leaf, so it's not just like empty branch. The leaf, I'm not going to make it as detailed because it's just more like entourage. Looks like would be better if there was one more leaf. I don't know, feels like two is not enough. It should be either one or three. It's another thing. Always have to look at your picture and check if it looks natural and organic, or is something looking weird. Okay, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed my lesson. Make sure you sign up or subscribe for the channel. Give me a like if you like it. And thank you for watching. Bye-bye.